So I said, "Hey girl, do you like Wendy's?" And she was like, "Yes." And I was like, "That's perfect, because you're gonna love it when these nuts cross your face." Then that bitch charged me double.
Another hooker story. That's great. But I thought you have a certain centre-back goalkeeper to save.
Fuck damn. So last time I won one, lost one, and we had one draw. But if I wanted to get sexy center back goalkeeper Rodriguez back, I had to win all three games this time. D-Day took his spot for the time being. Oh. Adriano, fuck you, fuck you, fuck you, fuck you, eat a dick. Can't do it. Oh pal, oh fatty, you can stay on the bench, Adriano. Pal. Michael Jadson was in no condition to play. He needed a break to clear his mind, so we got us someone new. Say hello to Jar Jar Binks Ronaldinho. The coolest character ever. Kids will adore him. But seriously, George Lucas. That piece of shit ruined Star Wars. But there's someone else. Since fatty fat fat Adriano had to take his fat ass to the bench and Rodriguez's life is on the line, I had to turn to the dark side. I had to use him, meet, well it, that arrogant pace of using whore. He is so fucking overpowered. But I won't lose sexy center back goalkeeper Rodriguez. So my road to save Rodriguez began. This was my enemy, including the shadow man. But we had over-penised Wellington, so he was in for a pounding. So right from the get-go we used the fact that there is a probably very gay person at EA with a boner for Wellington. He cut inside and got us a penalty. Since our fatty fat Adriano and SCGK Rodriguez were missing, he took it himself. Well, at least they didn't over-penis his penalty kicks. He tried another cheeky ball into the net but missed. Look at his arrogance. He is all like, come at me bro. This guy was a fucking one-man show so far. But his arrogance made him blow all his chances. But then Michael Bastos sent the ball to Jar Jar Binks Ronaldinho and Wellington scored. Over fucking powered. So Wellington broke the ice to save Rodriguez. And Jar Jar Binks Ronaldinho followed his lead. Why did you have to ruin Star Wars? Why? Now hell broke loose. They knew they had to do everything to save sexy center back goalkeeper Rodriguez. Stop the bleeding of their team. Oh, it's Valdivia. So what do you think will happen now? If you thought to yourself something very cocky, you were goddamn right. Thank you, cocky Valdivia and MC Gady. I was so proud. We were dominating. Even Chris Brown would be jealous of the beating we were handing out. Nice work there, buddy. You piss poor excuse of a human being. So it was going great. But one special MC wanted more. It was time again to say thank you, MC Gady. MC Gady. Why as a Gato? Why? Taking all the credit? What's wrong with you? That's pretty dickish. You just made my list, pal. We were rolling, guys, and there was some pounding left. Stealing dick as a Gato passed to Wellington and he mocked my enemy with some arrogance. 5 goals and we didn't even concede once. Fuck, Matthew McConaughey. Well, it didn't matter. We won our first game and had 10 points in Division 4. But most importantly, Rodriguez was still alive.
George, may I ask you something? Are you gay?
What? No, fuck you. You are gay.
So you're 100% sure you only like women?
I like my woman how I like my glasses. Sitting on my face. I like my woman how I like my golf scores. in the 80s with a slight handicap.
Sometimes I am afraid of what's going on in your brain, George. George, are you still with me?
Shut up, faggot. We had no reason to change our team. This was our best starting 11 since Michael Jadson needed time to get his head back into the game. Our enemy had his own MC Gady, so we had to be careful. Over penis Wellington started to dominate right from the start, but again he should convert more. After some more pace abusing, Philippe headed the ball into the net. All these guys were fighting for sexy center back goalkeeper Rodriguez. Even though I started to think Philippe might have dementia because he thought he shot it with his foot, the old man fired another shot still thinking about his foot. Dementia got him good, they all were sharp. They were playing beautiful football and finally I got some security with a 2-goal lead. Well, it made the game so much more fluid than fatty fat fat Adriano. But then it happened, Dumbia was free through on goal and fucking poached that ball into the net. We could not lose this game. We could not lose SCGK Rodriguez, so Paris Hilton had some ball fondling to do, but all in all it was nothing too dangerous. In the end we won the game and were one step closer to save him. Just one more game. Come on, we also won the division title and got promoted. But then the telephone rang again. Hello, I've got a huge penis. Who are you?
How is it going, George?
Oh my fucking god, it's you. Is sexy center back goalkeeper Rodriguez alive?
Yes. I'm he. Painfully. Misses you.
I don't get that. Why painfully?
Well, you could say he is having a hard time not being with you.
Is he having an erection or something?
Wow. Just wow.
You think so, Ringy? Well, I have Welly Ton, so I'll win the next game and save him.
One more thing, George. You have to use Michael Jackson in the next game.
Oh my fucking god, you bastard, he is not ready.
And Adriano.
Fatty fat fat. Seriously?
And they both have to score or Rodriguez is dead.
Why are you doing this to me?
I'm just like you, George. An asshole with too much time. Goodbye.
Depressed Jadson and fatty Adriano, Red Wedding standing by. Oh, Ringy. You're always right, so shit got as real as it can get. Fatty Adriano had to play for Wellington and the burden was on Michael Jadson again. I'm sorry, buddy, but I need you. We need you. So let's just hope our enemy doesn't have a strong team. Fuck. Poop. Oh shit, fuck damn. So this one was shaping up to be a tough fucking match for the life of our friend. We had to score with Adriano and Jadson, so let's just not concede. Fuck damn, so this shit just got harder. Bastos bastard had our first chance but blew it worse than my ex-wife. Then our fatty fat kid Adriano got a hold of the ball and then, Adriano, smash. Monster fatty monster fatty Adriano. So now it was up to Michael Jadson to save the day. He tried everything. Even though he was not in form, he fought. Trying to lose the fear of seeing another friend dead, but luck was not on his side so far. Like in the whole road to fucking glory, he was the guy who had to suffer the most. Come on, buddy. Come on, pal. You can do it. Jar Jar Binks Ronaldinho send a ball to our favorite fat kid, and what can I say else then? Adriano, smash. Monster fatty monster fatty Adriano. Monster fatty monster fat. So fatty Adriano was a real asset today. But still Jadson. Michael Jadson had to score to keep Rodriguez alive. And boy he tried, but he just could not hit it today. He could not believe it. What else can he do? He dribbled for his life. He fought. He needed to get that goal. What a man. So why the fuck did it not happen? Why? How much more blood can one man pour onto the pitch? Sometimes life is a bitch. You lose the things you love the most. But sometimes all you need is a good friend to pass you the fucking ball. He fucking did it. No, they fucking did it. The team saved Rodriguez. Thank you, Philippe. Thanks, Michael Jadson. Thanks, Fatty. Wow, this was a wild ride, guys.
I'm kinda impressed, George. Rodriguez will not die today.
Can I have him back now?
Not yet, George. He's not off the hook. You'll have to do more to get him back. Goodbye, George.
Fuck damn. Guys, did you like this episode? I've got another two questions for you and want to address something after that. This time I would like you to stay if it is okay with you. The first question is, should we start Adriano or Wellington in the next match? The second question is, how can we save Rodriguez and who is the murderer? There is a little clue in this episode again. Okay, now two things I want to tell you guys. The first one is, since I want this to be as interactive as possible, I decided to launch my Twitter career. Tell me your ideas, send me your songs. Ask me what the fuck you want, I might give some clues on who the murderer is and tweet about the production process. If you want, you can retweet this episode to all your friends. I would be rock hard for that. Let's meet and make this as fun as possible. Just follow the tweet symbol in this picture or search for the link in the description. The second thing is, I am amazed by the support from all you assholes out there. Special thanks to FlareGamerHD, he posted our squad to Foothead, and a day after that our community grew by 1,300 subscribers. To all you Foothead geeks, welcome aboard. You can find his channel in the description as well if you want to take a look at his videos. If you want, you can subscribe to my Twitter and to my channel. Please like this video and share it around. Love all you assholes out there. George is out.